So that he can stop you from going ahead. Some of the ways how the devil works. Pastor was telling us that God uses the truth. The truth. Praise the Lord. And the devil uses the truth for the confirmation.
And the facts.
Facts, yeah. The devil uses facts. Praise the Lord. When we go to the courts of law, this is Ugandan court, that the truth can live there. But there is no, there are no facts or evidence. There is nothing to testify about the doctor. There are no facts. So the devil uses things that can be
changed
to hinder the truth that you know. It doesn't matter what the devil is using. But
you
cannot outwit us. That as if we don't know the truth. Praise the Lord. The devil cannot outwit us. So the plan of the devil, like Pastor was sharing, is to bring his life that can be tangible. But the Bible has truth and facts. That the devil cannot outwit us. Meaning that us who know the truth, us who have got a revelation of the truth, us who have something that we know, that he cannot outwit us. As if we don't know his
again.
So this is the working of the devil. Is he brings things that are tangible. When I was thinking about it, I went and I read a scripture in 1 Samuel. Don't open. Starting from verse 6, 8 and
9.
When the Philistine was attacking David, when he was attacking the army of God, praise the Lord. They knew that whoever was not circumcised cannot defeat someone who is not circumcised. So that one was the child of God. Praise the Lord. If whoever was not circumcised were not in the covenant as the children of God. And verse 5 says, and 6 and 7 even 8, the Bible says that Goliath was born. That if there was any battle and they were in the valley, but the scriptures say he's calling for someone to come and defeat him. You know the truth that there's no person who is not circumcised that can defeat
us.
But the devil is using certain facts to kill the truth that you know. So the scriptures say, so they start describing his teacher. That he had a spear and he carried it on the
way.
The length of his arm was not
straight.
Even his chest was given and there was no place where someone could hit him. So the life of Goliath was covered. He had shields upon him. And he had a blessing. And it's only this place where he hadn't covered. That's the thing that can show that you can't defeat him. Even if he wanted to kill that truth that they knew. So what does the devil use to kill the truth that you know? So he uses the facts that you know that are evident. So when they're going to fight, they've already described his armory. He has kept himself in the breast. And then he's putting on that thing, that
element.
And you cannot send anything to him. That is the truth. Confirming that there's no one who can defeat that
thing.
It is the confirmed truth. It has the tangible evidence. And that is what the devil does. But Pastor was telling us in the morning that besides the lie of the devil, what does the truth say? He was telling us the truth that we already know. Praise the Lord. The Jews, when they were attacking the
Philistines,
they forgot the truth that was given to them. And they looked at the facts upon Goliath. And for 40 days they were saying, you see that man. That there's no one who can defy him, and he has challenged us for so long. Apart from one man, David, who had the truth. He said that what would the man who had killed the Philistine be given to? He knew a certain truth. So he did consider the bigness and the factor upon the big man. So the devil wants to outwit
us.
He wants to kill the evidence and the information that you have. Because of the evidence and the facts that he has upon you, praise the Lord. You could be sick and even have letters from the doctor that you're not going to be healed. So the devil can use the facts of the letter. So that's what the devil uses. But what is the truth? That's what Pastor was telling us in the morning. The Bible says that he heals all our diseases. Praise the Lord. And the plan of the devil is to bring that confirmation to kill the truth that is in your life. Your victory is for you standing strong on the truth that is in your life. Pastor was telling us that what truth do you know? It doesn't matter what the devil is showing you. What truth do you have? There's those facts that you saying. And the devil is showing you all those facts. There's no man on your account. But what truth do you have towards the education of your children? The Lord started a good work in us of educating our children. It doesn't matter whether I don't have any man on my account. When God starts on something, he wants to finish it. Praise the Lord. Praise God. The other thing that I got a revelation about, and Pastor spoke about it as well. Pastor, the devil has lies on individuals, and Pastor elaborated it. That let no one understand a person for you. If I know Patrick and the time I've taken with him, and I know who he is, and a person comes to me and they start telling me and explaining who Patrick is to me, and it is different from the time that I've spent with this person. The pastor was telling us that let us not
trust the lies
of the devil. That you hold on to the truth that you know about Patrick. Yesterday when I got this scripture, there's something that came to me. That this is what the devil does. He brings us another side. That when you see a person, take this as important. Never allow.
Always
mind about the small victories that a person has. Instead of focusing on the failures of that person, how many of you have understood that? So this is what the devil does. When he wants you to look at the weaknesses of that person, he never considers the victories of that person. But he points you to the failures of that person.
That
we can be victorious in our
lives. Praise the Lord.
It's for us not to pay attention on the weaknesses. That person has victories, and that's what you need to consider. Tell your friends
the
way that you can defeat the devil. Compared to what
we have.
Today
that there are certain things that we have, and you can't relate them to our past. Your tomorrow, the lies of
the
day, you can tell that
they
maybe I'm feeling on the
road.
But by this time tomorrow, the way you can silence the lies of the day, that they don't have the ability.
But by this time tomorrow,
the way you can silence the lies
of the day, that they don't have the ability.
I want to share this. So that you don't see things in their
own
it doesn't matter whether the devil has
the
power. It doesn't matter whether you have the confirmation. But what does the Bible talk about that? That we did not bring four children to be trapped. We didn't drink constantly, that was stupid.
Mukama
ibaza. Praise the Lord.
The truth I know, and these grand ones, they have finished school glory. Even if there are no jobs in Kampala, it's the truth I know. There is their job. You have your job. I may not see it, but this is the truth I know, that the Lord has helped you to study up to that level. You need that there are no jobs in Uganda, but the time has come for us to believe the truth about the word of God. There is the scripture which I talked about in the morning. We always read it. It is in Psalm 37,
7:19.
Can you read it?
Maybe. It says, they shall not be ashamed in the evil time, and in the days of failure, they shall be satisfied.
Amen. That is the truth. That is the truth. We see
during the time of
famine,
we shall be satisfied. I don't care what kind of famine it is.
This is the truth.
You shall not be put to shame.
There will be saving.
Even in times of famine, you will be satisfied.
Amen.
And that is the truth.
Stick. This is the truth. He who started the good work in you will finish it. But the devil is a
liar.
The devil can come and tell you. Now your child is in
P5.
Where will you get school fees for this year? It is the lie of the devil.
You
didn't have money. When this child started in
P1,
the grace which has helped me to take this child to this level, it's still there. It will take me on and on and on until I reach where I'm going. That is the truth. Are you ready to believe the truth? Or you want to believe the facts of the devil? This is the facts of the devil. The devil can say, you have only 100,000 on you. You have 4 children. They are going to school. Now, do you think that 100,000 will finish them? Even if I have 100,000 on my account, I don't mind. This is the truth I know. I come to God. I tell God to give me money for my children. Why? It is written in Philippians 4:19 that my Father, my God, will supply all my needs, including school fees. Hear this proverb. According to his riches, not according to what I have, not according to what is on my account. The Lord provides according to his riches, not according to what I have, not according to the bigness of my wallet. That is the truth. I will walk by the truth, and live by the truth, and speak the truth until a miracle happens. What do you know about God? That is the truth. Live by the truth. Speak by the truth. Believe the truth. The Lord will supply. Even if I'm in the desert, it once happened. Rebels fed a prophet. Rebels fed the prophet. There were evil times. There were no food all over. Everyone was dying. But this man was feeding. This man had enough on his plate. The same God who did it. He's the same God I worship. That's the truth I have. I want to warn you. Don't look at things. Look at Jesus, the author and the finisher of your faith. Don't look at anything. Don't look at Ugandan economy. Don't look at the economy. Look at Jesus. Our help comes from God, not from the economy of Uganda. Our economy, our help comes from above. Your your friend? Who am I looking at? You are looking at your relative in the United Kingdom. You are looking at your relative in USA. Automate. Don't look at those people. But you watch your internet.
They experience the same thing.
They are
contaminated.
Train yourself to look at Jesus. Stick your eyes on Jesus. The author and the finish of your faith. If you want to walk on water, if you want to do the impossible, look at Jesus. When you look at the waters, what you have, Peter? Peter,
He said,
Look
here.
Send his arms and daughters to feed the way.
Your parents haven't lost their money.
Holy. Mubisomi.
You study.
Mujafuni.
And you get this.
Siwa Bawe.
Not because they exist.
Nentulina Katunda Gulawes.
You open a door for you.
Oh, Lord,
you open for the
other.
You open yours.
It's
the truth. Wherever Adu goes,
he just
cannot traverse. That's the truth. When they get on the water, away is pain. And they cross over.
When
the Egyptians, they come back
and
the water comes back and covers them. If you
tell
other people's rumors, you wind up in your
business.
Just believe one thing. You stop at Kalewe in December. When you get to Kalewe, You take the other route and very
important.
You cannot go to the
This is our country. God can bless you when you are here. And then you travel the world to see how the world was created, but not because there is no blessing in Uganda. God can bless you in this country and prosper you in this country and take you to another level when you are here. That is the truth. But the, most of these brethren are already lying. Listen, after this degree, I'm going to Dubai. After this degree, I'm going to Dubai. You can be here and proceed. I'm not against going to Dubai. When the Lord goes, tells you to go to Dubai, he'll go ahead of you and he'll make money there.
That's not the issue.
Satan is not going to do
with your problems.
You
traverse many churches like
five.
Even
though
it's much better than the
others.
The job that advertised. Because within
Then you submit
your papers.
Reading.
You janitor.
Okay.
Invite me to an
interview.
The thing is, a lonely job. You will never understand
anything.
Yes, go in.
Yes, we put together.
And that's the truth concerning people.
Now the truth about God. This is the truth I know. I am not ahead. Sorry, I'm not a tailor. I must be up, above, and above only. According to scriptures, we shall be above, not beneath. Above only, not beneath. The Lord will keep me there, because it is written that I should be above. You're supposed to be above. The truth, you know,
I'm a servant,
will set you free.
Then I'm following the
Amen.
Amen.
What you
know?
Talking about
you shall not die. You will live.
No,
will
live in
the world. The works of God.
It doesn't mean that death will never come. Death can show up, but it can swallow you, because there is a word on you. That is the truth.
Ishmael was almost dying.
And if he had died,
there would be no
Arabia,
because he is the
descendant.
But almost dying, he just spoke the truth. He told the mother,
Agar.
Hagar,
don't
you see the child
will die?
Because God spoke that
we
make him a great nation. That's what Hagar needed to
do.
So that the child wouldn't die. Today, there's a
one
that
just
spoke about
it.
When death wants to swallow,
when the business square,
the collapse of your business,
you have the
one.
This is second of talking of far, and then what? Declare the works of the Lord. In other words, testify. You will not die, but live. And then testify. Before the testimony, it means God will do something. Praise the Lord.
Amen. You shall not die. Do you have a word? Do you? The one you have is the truth you bear. The truth I know. That everything we have is not lasting. Is that permanent? The truth I
know.
What God can do. What is done for others? He can do it for you. What is done for others? God works in his season.
Season your
family.
Season
of
the
young
man.
As a one for
the young man.
Season your man.
Season pick up a phone.
After that motorboat, If you begin to work, begin to pay.
Patricia Bale, China.
Patricia
Bale
to China. Still on the throne.
Echi sachichariyo. Asumana ukutuara. Awala unna. Maybe we will be natural. Give Patricia. When my father and my mother forsake me, the Lord will take me up. The Lord will take me up. The Lord will take me up. I download that truth from the Holy Spirit. I can ask and someone puts up his hand. Because that is the truth. Then he asks. And I've already asked. I want someone who has paid in his name to come and stand here. The truth I know that Jesus is here. By his stripes, we are here. If someone come. That is the truth.
Did you call me?
Stand here.
Yeah.
That's
the truth I know. Truth says, by his stripes we are healed. The truth says that.
Now you come again.
And God is going to heal you as well.
rise up and come over here.
Behind
you,
heal. What happened? Have you ever told Jesus?
Mulinya ya Yesu.
Jesus.
Ndagira pay. Mulinya ya
Yesu.
Ekitiwa n'ettendo.
Mulinya
ya Yesu. Omwana akato. Ndagira pay. Ebadde mukono gwe. Ku Kristo Yesu. Amen. Waliwo omuntu
alimu. Ever since they have begun, Can I possibly see that person? It's there, deeply seated. That your days are not bad. You're not careful. Oh my God.
They
want you to kill an
answer.
Because
you're
come to demystify
those
that come from God.
Yes,
you can be careful. But you're still very
important.
You're still important. Can I speak another truth? Your joy, your lips, so that you go to food. Well,
After this one,
we shall
be happy to see.